Hey everyone, this is S.M. Pratt, and today we're going to take a look at the first edition Gym Hero set. This was released in August 2000 with 132 cards. If you're a fan of Ken Sugimori, there's going to be a ton of Ken Sugimori artwork. In fact, if you grew up during the original red, blue, and yellow era, you might have this player's guide. This was my player's guide for the original games. This is my first impression of Pokemon, but there's a ton of Sugimori artwork in this guide that we will see throughout the gym series. So let's get right into it, starting with Blaine's Moltres. This card is memorable for a couple of reasons. You'll notice right away, Moltres is a little bit in the background. Let me zoom out a little bit. You can see all these other Pokemon are front and center. But Moltres a little bit off to the side. But the most memorable part about this card is the 5 energy cost. For anyone who plays the actual game, 5 energies is terrible. This is a card that you don't want in your deck, but you want it in your binder. So there you go. There is Blaine's Moltres. Moving on to Brock's Rhydon. Then we have Aeracle's Clefable. This is a good example of Nishida. This will probably be the second most artist you'll see in this set. Then we have Erica's Dragonair. This is probably the card I think of first when I think of Gym Heroes. This is one of the more prominent cards. For some reason, this one always comes to mind. I think it's because of nice quality art. Then you have Erica's Vileplume. For some reason, this Vileplume is dark. All the evolution for this Vileplume line were super dark. We'll see them later on. Then we have LT Surge's Electabuzz. This is probably a good time to showcase the difference between the template of the cards. You'll notice on the bottom, this is the base set Shadowless Raichu. You see that weakness, resistance, and retreat cost. Looks a little bit different on the gym set. There's that Ken Sugimori profile picture there of every single gym leader, so you can see that throughout the set, but there you go. There's a good comparison of the difference in the template. And then moving on, we have the Super Saiyan Fearow. I always thought this looked a little bit like the Ho-Oh from the first episode. You can see that kind of like yellow aura around Fearow there. Yeah, I know we're getting deep into it. I know this is just Fearow, but just giving you a little nerdy interpretation. Then we have LT Surge's Magneton, another Sugimori artwork, and then Misty Seadra to finish off this page. And moving on, we have Misty's Tentacruel. We have Hitmonchan, and then another Moltres. You'll see that throughout the gym series, where you'll see the same species have multiple cards. Here's our first example of that. Then we have Rocket Scyther. Now, the Sabria's Gengar, we're going to pause a little bit on this. There's a bit of a difference between the English and the Japanese. I remember noticing this censorship. I think I posted a couple years ago on E4. So if you take a look at the Japanese, you'll notice, first and foremost, the English one's a bit stretched out. They just stretch out the image. But more importantly, you could see to the left the graveyard behind the Japanese Gengar. And on the right, it looks like Gengar's maybe in a nuclear test desert. There's not much going on there in the background. In my opinion, the Japanese one looks much more regal. It looks much better. It looks like a ghost in a graveyard. And it's very common for, you know, the English side of things to censor any type of religious anything. So that's why I think they knocked out those graves in the back. But there you go. Nonetheless, there's a good contrast between the two. And then moving on, we have the trainers. This is probably another good time to mention how the Japanese release not only was different in censorship, but there are cards in here that simply weren't in the first set. So this is supposed to be the first 4 gym leaders, Brock, Misty, LT Surge, and Erica, but for some reason they decided to pepper in some Sabrina and Blaine as well. So that's a big difference from the English and Japanese release. So then we have the Rocket's Trap to finish us off with the holo cards. Moving into the rares, starting with Brock's Golem, just have another Sugimori art. This was kind of interesting, one of the few CGI species you'll see in the set, that classic late 90s CGI. Then moving on to Brock's Rhyhorn, I think we'll see another one of him later. Brock Sandslash. Then we got Brock Zubat. I always remember this Clefairy for some reason. I don't know if that contrasts with the background. Then we got Erica's Victory Bell. And then our second Electabuzz. And then moving on to the LT Surge's Raichu. That little edgy lightning in the back. Then we have Misty's Cloyster. Misty's Goldeen. Really like how they do this. Even though this is a stock Sugimori, I really like how they make it look like, you know, he's running at you or punching or whatever it is. I like those action shots. You see another one down here where they just, you know, make it a little more off-center. It just gives it a little more, I don't know, a little more personality. Then we got Misty's Tentacool. And this was a little bit of a change-up. You don't see too much of Yoshida in the set, but this is definitely, you can tell the difference between all these other Sugimori illustrations right away. Even if you're not big into Pokemon, that one stands out a little bit. Then we got our Sabrina's Venomoth. Blaine's Growlithe on fire, apparently. Gotta love that late 90s style. And then we have Blaine's Kangaskhan, and then another Blaine's card again. This is not part of the Japanese set, but they're peppered in the English release. Then we got Brock's Geodude, Brock's Golbat. We have an apparently flying Brock's Graveler. Then we have Lickitung in the Hills of Sound of Music. Then we have a nice little Erika's Dratini and Erika's Execute. That one looks a little bit, yeah, it's definitely Nishida. I was going to say it looks a little bit different from the Sugimori. Then we have Erika's Executor and then Gloom. There's that darkness I'm talking about. It's that, it's pretty much all of them are black. It was the first dark type, dark and plant. Then we have Erika's Gloom again. Another example of same species, two cards. Erika's Oddish. And then Erika's Weeping Bell, apparently crushing on something we can't see off screen. Then another Erika's Weeping Bell. Then we have LT Surge's Magnemite, LT Surge's Raticate. LT Surge wasn't too good at picking the Pokemon. LT Surge's Spearow. Then we have Misty's Poliwhirl, Misty's Psyduck. This one's also available in a gold W stamp. Then we have a couple more Misty's up here with the little red Kaioken power aura around them. Then this one right here, I think a lot of people remember this back in the day. I remember when I was a kid, it would always blow my mind if there was like another Pokemon or another trainer or something in the card. And when you look at this now, it's like length, 2 feet, 11 inches. Misty's probably a safe 5 feet. This guy's got to be like 25 feet easy. So I don't know what's going on here, what Sugimori was thinking, but I like what's happening. I like that Misty is there in the background. Speaking of quality art and background, this Haunter is a great example of something that is inexpensive but will deliver. This is probably no more than $20 to $30 PSA 10. See that little nice ghastly silhouette? Its previous evolved form in the left corner. Then Gengar, its later evolved form in the bottom right. Very nice concept. Good old Nishida delivering. Then we have Sabrina's Jinx. Sabrina's Slowbro. We have Blaine's Charmander with the spike on his back. That little bump right there above his arm, that is indeed a spike. He had that probably about till 97, I think. And then it was rotated out when released in English. But of course, it's the old original Sugimori art, so that's why the spike is still there. We have Blaine's Growlithe and then Blaine's Ponyta. Really like this Tauros. This reminds me, there's a card in Neo. I can't remember the exact name, but it's basically an older man in a field with a Dragonite just chilling. Really reminiscent of that same artwork. Then we have Blaine's Vulpix, really like that, eating the Pokeball. Brock's Geodude, Brock's Mankey, another Brock's Mankey, and another Brock's Onix, and another Brock's Rhyhorn with a friggin' 70 attack. I remember when I was younger, I was like, how does this dude have a 70 attack? But if you read the fine print, it's obviously not that playable. Then we have Brock's Sandshrew. Then we have Brock's Sandshrew over here lamenting about life, looking off to the sunset. Then we have another Brock's Vulpix. I think I like the one in the Pokeball a little bit more. Then we have Brock's Zubat, Erika's Bellsprout, another Erika's Bellsprout, and then Erika's Execute. Look at this big diesel egg in the middle. What the heck? Why is this guy like 5 times the size of everybody else? Then we have Erika's Oddish, Erika's Tegla, LT Surge's Magnemite, then LT Surge's Pikachu. Anytime there's a Pikachu, it is a Pikachu, so a Pikachu collector will want it. Then we have LT Surge's Rattata, and then Spearow. God, LT Surge is just with the low-tier Pokemon over here. And then Voltorb. Then we have Misty's Goldeen, Misty's Horsea, Misty's Poliwag, Misty's Seal. I don't know, with that tongue sticking out, keeping that theme going with tongue sticking out. Misty's Shellder, then Misty's Staryu. And then the Sabrina cards that, again, weren't in Japanese, that were added as well. Really like that Drowsy there. Nishida really brings some attitude or, you know, some personality to the cards. And then finishing off with the Venonat doing Removal Beam. That's what that attack is. Okay. And the trainer cards are something a little bit fresh, I think, because a lot of us didn't look at the trainer cards back in the day. They're kind of a new, old card, if that makes sense. I think a lot of people aren't familiar with the trainers, so let's get into it. So we got Blaine's Quiz, number one. Then we have the non-hollow Brock, and then the charity card featuring Erika. The thing I like about these non-hollow trainers is they're a little bit different. Let me see if I can pull up that page. So get a good look at those. Those are the non-hollow variants. And then you can see the difference between the hollows. A little more full body, It's a little more focused on the upper body. I like that. Anytime you do a little variant, it's always quality. Any unique art is a good thing. We have the no removal gym. I remember back in the day, somebody wanted to trade a Japanese version of this for a base set unlimited Charizard. Definitely didn't do that deal. We have the Rockets team training gym. Nice 90s CGI. Blaine's last resort. You can tell he's heated. Then we have Brock's trainings method. Celadon City Gym. Cerulean City Gym. All that CGI. Then we have Erica's maids. Okay. Didn't know she had maids on staff. Erica's perfume. We're just getting all up in Erica's life right now. Then we have good manners. This is Erica again. We have LT Surge's treaty. I'd probably go for a treaty if I was raising Raticates and Spearows. Then we have Minion Team Rocket. I really like this card. I think this is pretty reminiscent of those other trainers over here. They did a good job keeping that theme going. Then we have Misty's Wrath. Pewter City Gym. This recall just screams Team Rocket. Just looks like that Rocket set. Then we have Sabrina's ESP. And then last but not least, we have a few more of these trainer cards. Secret Mission. God, that tick. Look at that quality art. That's just straight Team Rocket right there. Vermilion City Gym. Blaine's Gamble just living on the edge. I don't know why. Every time I see energy card like this, I think Magic the Gathering. But there's our Energy Flow. Misty's Duel. Narrow Gym. Sabrina's Gaze. And then Trash Exchange. But Sabrina's Gaze is going to be the last one we're going to look at here because it was another censored art. So on the right, this is the Sabrina's Gaze I think most people are accustomed to. At least for me. That's what I think of when I think of Sabrina's Gaze. So back then, this card was considered offensive. And this was not even with the PC culture that we have today. This was considered to be flipping the bird. That apparently is considered to be flipping the bird. So what they did for English is they stripped Sabrina of her master's ball, gave her this raggedy Pokeball, and she doesn't get to keep it. She has to toss it. So this is the English release. And even for me, like, this is like maybe the third time I've ever seen this artwork because everybody values the censored artwork because there's more story, more history, just more everything. So there you go. That's another example of cards that were censored. And we'll see a couple more when we get into the gym challenge set in the next video. But there you go, guys. That is the Gym Heroes set. As usual, let me know your thoughts. Hopefully this is entertaining, informative, and that is pretty much it. Until next time.